One day, an unseasonal rain began to fall. It was so heavy that it caused widespread flooding that reached the Buddha's place of residence. Concerned for the Buddha's safety, Uruvela Kassapa jumped in a boat and rushed to the Buddha. Samana! Monk! Where are you? Samana! Where are you? Monk! Where are you? Are you okay? Kassapa, I am here. I am fine. Due to the Buddha's abilities, the water did not come close to where the Buddha resided. Everywhere the Buddha stepped, the water moved away. The Buddha then flew into the sky above Uruvela Kassapa. Uruvela Kassapa, in shock, thought, "This monk can also fly? He is so great, but he is still not an arahant like I am." By this time, the Buddha had been with Uruvela Kassapa for 2 months. Although he showed Uruvela Kassapa many marvels, Uruvela Kassapa still stubbornly insisted that he was an arahant and the Buddha wasn't. The Buddha then said, "Uruvela Kassapa, why do you deceive yourself? You tell yourself you are an arahant, even though you know you are not. You still have greed, fear, jealousy, delusion, and anger. Not only do you deceive yourself, but you also deceive others. You are not an arahant. You know this. Your practices have not led to the result you desire. If your practice does not start with right view, it cannot lead you to becoming an arahant."
"You are right. You are right. I am not an arahant. I know it, and it shames me. Everyone thinks that I am, and I let them. I can feel it inside me, the feeling of incompleteness. I know I am not done. I am so ashamed. I've been lying for so long."
"Kassapa, you have been practicing the wrong path, and it has led to the wrong result. If you practice my path, you will become an arahant."
"Yes, I will practice your path. Ordain me, my lord. I am ready."
"Kassapa, you are a teacher with many followers. You are like a father to them. You must first tell them of your intentions before I ordain you." So, on the next day, Uruvela Kassapa assembled his students and told them all about the majesty and magnificence of the Buddha. Uruvela Kassapa expressed his intention to ordain as a disciple of the Buddha. His students responded, "Teacher, where you go, we will follow. We trust you and will do as you do." And so, Uruvela Kassapa and his students cut off their matted hair and donned discarded robes. They floated their hair and old clothes down the river. The hair and belongings of Uruvela Kassapa and his students floated down the river to the encampment of his second brother, Nari Kassapa. One of the students of Nari Kassapa saw the hair and clothes floating in the river, and quickly informed his teacher. Dania Akhmedova thought,
"What could have happened to my brother and all his students that would make them cut off their hair and forsake their old clothes?"
Dania Akhmedova quickly went to check on his brother.
"Brother, is everything all right? You cut off your hair and are wearing robes like that monk." "Nadi, I've come to realize that the path I have followed will never lead me to enlightenment. I have faith now that if I walk the path of the Buddha, I can definitely reach enlightenment." "Brother, I have always had faith in you and trusted your judgment. If you think that this Buddha can guide you to enlightenment, then I too will join his Sangha."
Dania Akhmedova and his 300 students cut off their hair, donned discarded robes, and ordained under the Buddha. They floated their hair and clothes down the river. A student of Dania Akhmedova saw all the hair and clothes floating down the river and quickly alerted his teacher. Dania Akhmedova, recognizing the hair and clothes of his brothers Uruvela and Dania Akhmedova, was very concerned. He rushed to see his brothers and found them wearing robes just like the Buddha. Dania asked his brother,
"Brother, have you gone forth under the Buddha? What about the path we used to follow?" "Dania, my dear youngest brother, I've gone forth under the Blessed One, the Buddha. I have realized after all these years that the path we followed will never lead to enlightenment." "Brother, if you see this as the right path, I too will follow. I have always respected you and will do as you have done."
The youngest Kassapa brother, Dania, along with his 200 students, cut off their matted hair and floated it down the river.
What did you learn from this story? We hope you enjoyed the video. Click like if you did, and click subscribe if you want to see our uploads.